there's that energy.
Oh, unbelievable. Really just like pouring gasoline on the fire for our momentum that we had. I mean, we had some really good internal numbers going in the first part of the week. We had a great day Monday with the Dooley family and endorsement. Coach Vince Dooley, Neil Bortz, Randy Evans tweeted he's voting for me real high in Republican circles, ambassador that Trump appointed. And we got Hunter Hill's huge endorsement on Tuesday, and in the middle of Clay Tippin's endorsement on Wednesday, we got the president's tweet. And despite the momentum, that's really just taking our energy to another level. A lot of people coming our way as we close the campaign, and we've said from day one we want our best day to be our last, and that's what we've been doing the last 2 days, literally working hard on the ground, just, you know, continuing to get people to move our way, get our voters back to the polls. I personally feel like our folks are a lot more motivated and energized right now, but like I told the crowd tonight, none of that matters unless we get the vote out. So that's our message to folks. We've got to get out there and finish the drill.
I know you don't like those polls, but what about, what do you think about that, having such a large percentage of Republican voters who are kind of undecided?
Well, I don't pay too much attention to the polls. I can get a better feel for how I feel on the ground on things. That seemed like a high number of undecideds to me, but it doesn't matter. You know, what matters is Tuesday. That's what we're focused on. We need our folks to get out there and, you know, let's get this done.
You talked about public safety reform earlier today, that in Midtown Atlanta there was actually a rally against police brutality. So what do you think about bridging that gap between people who feel like they don't have really a chance against?
Well, absolutely. As somebody that has, you know, run a law enforcement division or oversees one in the Secretary of State's office, 20 post-certified people, 38 investigators, you know, you have bad apples. They need to be held accountable. But it doesn't mean we don't need to stand up for those that are literally being shot down in cold blood trying to protect our community. So you have to have that balance and hold people accountable, but in no way diminishes the support that we have for the men and women in blue, our troops, and also those first responders, fire, EMT, and others that are out there working hard every day.
Yesterday, you had a pretty important person speak on your behalf. Did you get to talk to him? Do you have any advice leading up to the primary?
No, it was electric in Macon yesterday. Unbelievable crowd down there. The fire marshal was trying to close the doors on us. We had so many people going. The vice president was absolutely great. Committed the president and himself their full endorsement, their total support. They are with us. You know, we are in it to win it. They feel like I'm the best person to be the governor of Georgia and to win in November. And I think he would tell you when he saw that crowd yesterday, he knows why our motivation and momentum was where it was in the polls when they made the endorsement. But it was a huge help to us to kind of clear through the muck that was out there. And we've remained positive talking about putting Georgians first. And he talked about that yesterday and, you know, said I was the real deal for the governor's race. And that means a lot.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.